Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this quick tip, we are going to talk about rasterize as an effect. Now, in that video about pixel-based effects, we have seen that rasterizing an object can solve issues that we have with raster-based effects. So you apply object, rasterize, and then you get a pixel image out of that object. The downside of that procedure is after you have rasterized it, you can no longer edit it. And also the paths are gone. So basically, you would have to keep the original object or you would have to keep the original file in order to proceed. And that might fall on your feet later. So it's better to keep things editable. And that's why we have rasterize as an effect. So effect, rasterize. And in here, you can also add around the object. So let's add 20. And we can check out how we set up the background. And of course, it's important to set up the resolution, because when later on you apply raster-based effects, then of course you need sufficient resolution, and also the raster-based effects, they look differently when applied at different resolutions. And we can just set this to high, and that's okay. Now, this has not changed anything as for the editing possibility, so this is just, let's deselect that. Okay, so this is still editable. You can just select the text and edit that. And when you zoom in, of course, you get those pixels. So let's get rid of that highlight. I'm going to turn off the smart guides like so. And now you see, this is, of course, the rasterizing that causes those pixels. I'm going into the appearance panel once more, and let's check out the settings. We have set the anti-aliasing to none, and it would be better to set this to type optimized or maybe art optimized like this. And then we get a smoother edge, which is just nicer. So why would you want to do that? Now, of course, you can now go on and apply those effects to it. And then you see these work better and they are not clipped on the right side. That's one reason to do that. And when you apply raster-based effects, then in the end, you get a raster-based output anyway. So you can rasterize before applying the rasterized effect, and that's just fine. Another reason to do that is when you're in the process with your client and the artwork goes back and forth, and maybe in the process of discussing this, you do not want to give them the vector-based artwork because you want to give them that only after they have paid your invoice. So what you can then do in order to have that output is, of course, you can output it as JPEG. But if you have the rasterize effect applied and then export a PDF, maybe multiple pages, then inside that PDF, the effect would be applied and you have raster-based artwork in the PDF, but in your AI file, everything is editable. And that's the reason why the rasterize effect even exists.